In this video, I'm going to introduce you to building a simple molecule within IQmol. So as long as I'm in build mode, which I am, since the tools are selected and I have a hammer in the middle of my screen, I can go ahead and just click, which will add an atom. So I've added here a carbon atom, and if I wanted that to be a different atom, say I want it to be an oxygen, all I need to do is come up here to where the carbon symbol is, and select whatever element I want it to be. So I'm going to go ahead and turn that into an oxygen. And so I select the oxygen, and then I just need to come back and click on the atom to turn it into an oxygen atom. Now I can add an additional atom by clicking on the one I already did and click and hold and then drag away from it. And that creates a second atom attached to the first one. And I can continue doing that. Maybe I want to make ozone. So here I have three oxygen atoms that are all connected with single bonds. Sometimes I need to indicate that there are multiple bonds. And so the way that that's done is by clicking on one of the pre-existing atoms, and again hold and drag to meet another one. And then when you release, it forms a double bond here. I could repeat this process for a triple bond. But it's going to be more helpful for me to talk about a specific molecule that has some different atoms in it. So I'm going to go ahead and turn this into formaldehyde. Formaldehyde has one carbon as its central atom, and it's connected to an oxygen with a double bond, and then that would be connected to two hydrogens. So I can change the identity of these elements, again, by going to the periodic table. So if I select carbon, I can come over and click on the center atom, which turns it into a carbon. And then if I want the oxygen over here to be a hydrogen, I just need to click on it after selecting the hydrogen. Now, I could add another hydrogen the same way that I just did, or I can also make use of the add hydrogens feature. So the add hydrogens feature, if I go ahead and click on this, will just add a hydrogen until the valency of the atom is satisfied. Since carbon has four valence electrons, it likes to form four bonds. And it already had three, so it just needed to add one additional hydrogen to satisfy its four bonds. Now, this molecule looks a little funny at the moment. These carbon and hydrogen bonds should be equivalent, but they're very much not. So in order to make them equivalent, we need to go ahead and optimize the structure, and we can do that using this energy minimization tool. So here the E with the green arrow, if I go ahead and click on that, it will basically adjust the molecule so that the bonds are at a more realistic length and angle. And when I do that, you'll also notice that it prints an energy down here in the bottom corner. It says UFF energy. And that is basically a relative energy. So you can use those when you're trying to kind of get a rough idea, but it's not an absolute energy. So that energy is really only ever used for comparing two structures with exactly the same number of atoms. So now I have formaldehyde, which is a carbon atom connected to an oxygen and two hydrogens. And this molecule has symmetry. So in that case, it's generally good practice to symmetrize your molecule, which you can access through the build menu. It doesn't actually do much except it reorients the molecule so that it's centered and it symmetrizes the coordinates, which is important if you're going to go on and do further quantum chemistry calculations. But it moved my molecule, and now it's in kind of an awkward position, and I want to be able to see it. So I want to go back to manipulate mode, which is my hand here, and I can now twist it around so that I can see the whole molecule. That's about it for building molecules. A couple of quick things to point out. If you need to get rid of an atom or a bond, an easy way to do that is to use the magic wand. Select whatever you want to get rid of. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the hydrogen atom and then click the red X. Maybe I also want to get rid of this double bond. I could select that and click the X. And also, I just want to show you real quickly what would happen if I had added hydrogens at this point. So if I had a carbon and an oxygen with a single bond between them, and I went ahead and added the hydrogens, I would end up adding three hydrogens so that carbon again has four bonds, oxygen has two, and if I wanted this again to be more realistic, I would want to minimize the energy. So this molecule is now methanol. It's a different molecule. It has more hydrogen, but just to illustrate another example.